homes that were damaged in Moscow are historic homes. They were actually used for the Underground Railroad. And tonight, Adam Clements is finding out if they're going to be able to be saved.
Many in the town of Moscow have lost everything, their homes, their cars, all of their belongings. But the town itself has also lost something it holds very near and dear to its heart.
It's very heartbreaking because it's been here so long.
Next door to Vicki Dale's battered and beaten home lies a significant slice of American history.
They would put candles in the windows so the slaves could cross over safely.
Long before Moscow was ravaged by one of the most vicious storms in tri-state history, the small river town acted as a safe haven for slaves fleeing the South. Two homes in particular, the Fee Villa House and the large brick home next door, played a vital role in the Underground Railroad.
There was supposed to be a tunnel underneath the road where if they came to check, they would move them underneath.
Now, these historical landmarks, nearly 200 years old, lie broken on the banks of the river. A substantial loss for this tradition-rich community.
So any village has its character, and its character is reflected by its houses and its dwellings. In Moscow, that's probably true more than most places because we have so many buildings that have history even predating the Civil War. So it'll be a sad thing, if these houses can't remain.
News 5 has learned tonight that the brick home next to the Fee Villa suffered such severe damage, it will unfortunately have to be leveled. Vicki Dale is yet to learn the fate of her own home. Still, she says losing this piece of history is a tough pill to swallow.
They used to have tours and everything. It's just heartbreaking to see that going to be gone.
199 years and counting. The great tornadoes of 2012, just another page in the history of this historic river town. Fortunately, the Fee Villa House is going to be restored sometime in the near future. In Moscow, Adam Clements, News 5.